Well, I'm going to speak to people in North Korea, and I'm going to speak to my people who are over in North Korea, and a lot of things are happening. I have a good relationship with Kim Jong-un. That's a very important thing. I can now, wait, I can now call him. I can now say, well, we have a problem. I told him, I gave him a very direct number. He can now call me if he has any difficulty. I can call him. We have communication. It's a very good thing. People are shocked that this is the kind of, you know, they thought Trump was going to get in. He was going to start throwing bombs all over the place. It's actually the opposite.
Well, that's President Trump, as you can see, on the White House driveway talking to our Peter Doocy and the other White House reporters right after he talked to Peter's father, Steve Doocy. As you heard, he was talking about his planned phone call that's going to happen tomorrow with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. This, of course, follows the historic summit with the North Korean dictator. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, meanwhile, says a lot of work has to be done with the regime, including being able to identify its nuclear facilities.
We have a reasonable understanding. It is incredibly important that we get a full understanding of that as quickly as possible. And as part of the efforts that will be undertaken in the week and weeks ahead, we will work with the North Koreans to come to have a fuller understanding of that so that we can begin to execute together the commitments that President Trump and Chairman Kim make.
So we have a reasonable understanding, not a full one. John Hanna joins us, former National Security Advisor to Vice President Dick Cheney. John, welcome. You know, this is where the rubber hits the road, as they say. You think are we going to get concrete moves, not promises, but specific steps by the North Koreans to open the nuclear sites to international inspectors and truly start the process, as is pledged, of denuclearization?
Well, that's a $64,000 question, Eric. We've been at this for 25 years with the North. We've had lots of statements in the past that we're headed in that direction, a verified, complete, irreversible denuclearization, and yet we never get there. The promise of what the president did this week is that he established this personal relationship with Kim Jong-un. That's something dramatically new, but we still haven't yet actually advanced the ball on this goal that's most important to the United States of denuclearization. That's the challenge that Secretary Pompeo has got to get after, and I think he needs to get after it very quickly. We've got to see some results on what we need from North Korea sooner rather than later.
What would you like to see?
Well, I think the first thing we've got is I would like to simply see a declaration from Chairman Kim to his people in Korean that at the end of this process with the United States, however long it takes, in exchange for viable security and economic guarantees from the international community, North Korea will have no nuclear program whatsoever or ballistic missile program. After that, I think they've got to come clean with a full declaration of what they've got, because as Secretary Pompeo says, we right now don't know whether they've got 10 nuclear weapons or 60 nuclear weapons. That's the dramatic variance we have in understanding the full scope and breadth of this nuclear infrastructure that the North has built up. Yeah. So we first got to have a clear understanding of what they've got. Then we've got to be able to get in there with our inspectors to verify it all.
So that, I mean, look, you're talking about a list. I mean, should they just provide a list? You've got nuclear warheads, you've got production facilities, you've got labs, you've got ballistic missile manufacturing sites, as well as the launch sites. I mean, do you expect that they will actually hand that over, or that'll be more of the same with their past behavior? They'll just, you know, it's the old spinning and waiting and delaying, you know. You know, what there's an old game in the streets of New York, watch the red, watch the black, watch the red, watch the black, and they just fool you.
Yeah, no, if history is any guide, that's exactly the path that we're headed on. That is the danger of the process we're embarked on now, that the North, as in the past, will simply play for time. They'll reduce their international isolation, and gradually they will begin with this charm offensive to erode the international sanctions that the Chinese, the South Koreans, the Russians will all begin to drop off in terms of their enforcement of sanctions. And then the North, over time, will be free and clear to continue to build up its nuclear program, all the while getting some economic concessions. The hope of what the president has done is that they have got to deliver a complete and final declaration of the full scope of their nuclear program that the United States and our other partners internationally can fully verify with inspectors on the ground. That's the goal that we've got to achieve, and we can't allow this process, as it has in the past, to simply drag on for months and months and months without satisfaction of key American concerns that a strategic decision has been made by Kim Jong-un and communicated to his people that the jig is up, and North Korea, in exchange for these guarantees
from the West. And should the president
tomorrow,
do you think the president should get that tomorrow, or can, or now is not the time on that level, in the phone call?
I think it's the job of Secretary Pompeo and the diplomats, but the president has got to make clear that time is short, and these are the types of things that Secretary Pompeo has got to get satisfaction on when he sits across the table from Kim Jong-un.
All right, John Hanna, thanks so much. In the next hour, by the way, we'll be talking about North Korea's human rights abuses and its human rights records. Professor Walter Hatch of Colby College, the Oak Institute of Human Rights, will be here on that. Next hour. John, thank you.